guys? Hey, I'm Jeff from the Kaddie Shack. Today, we're going to talk about how to make more power with your carburetors by just doing one of our Hi-Flo kits, moving the air cleaner bracket. Super simple, super inexpensive. It's an easy deal. We're just going to show you how this bracket works and why it works and how to install it. So the first basic thing, if you look at it, the stock air cleaner bracket sits like that. It's right in the middle of the carburetor. It impedes the airflow. Okay, I mean, the air is coming up through there. It's taking up a bunch of space. Now, what we do is we have a Hi-Flo kit. We're going to show you how to install it. What it does is it moves that bracket up and out of the carburetor throat. Okay, now, you know, a couple of years ago, I don't know, maybe 2-3 years ago, whatever it was, we did an article with Hot VWs where we actually dyno tested this same air cleaner bracket setup. We dyno tested a bunch of stuff. Dude, it made 8 horsepower. Moving the air cleaner bracket made 8 horsepower. I don't know if you've been on the dyno for any time at all. You know, sometimes you're struggling to make 1, 2, 3 horsepower. Dude, 8 horsepower moving with our Hi-Flo kit, our Kaddie Shack Hi-Flo kit, moving the air cleaner. So let's show you how to install this thing real quick. Not too bad. Pretty simple. And we just got a lid for a carburetor right now. Just make it easy. Put the cork gasket on, okay? Next thing you're gonna do, go ahead and put the air cleaner base on it. What I normally do here, real quick, insert that screw. Get it down, it's not all the way down, a little bit of room in there, not totally tight, okay? This is our standoff piece here, our locking washer and our screw, okay? The next one we just kind of dump in like that, let it sit there for a second. There we go. Put that over there. Take a look here. Can you see that? You can see it, right? All right. So the lock washer is over the bracket. That is, that screw gets in there, it's going to bite down on that bracket so it doesn't loosen on you. Just kind of guide that other piece over. Stick it in. Hold these two together. Okay. Tighten that dude down. Okay. We're putting a little pressure here on both of these. Tighten them down so they're kind of snug, and then give them a nice and tight. Okay, we don't want these rattling loose, right? Nice and tight. Let me get an air cleaner element. We're gonna toss it in there like that. These elements here, they're washable elements. Ones we normally use, washable elements. You treat them with air cleaner oil or baby oil. We'll get you another video on that. I'll show you, I promise. Look at the other video. Toss that dude in there. These are our old school air cleaners here, okay? Make sure that the perforated cage sits in the lip there. We do make two variations of this bracket, okay? Two of them. We've got one for the old school kind of deal, and another one for the newer air cleaners you'll find on the new carbs. They're taller. They're not much taller. They're a little bit taller. They have no cage, okay? Anyway, this is the old school kind of one. Put the bracket on there, rotate it around, click it down, it's done there. Okay, our kit here, it comes with a wing nut. It also comes with an EPDM seal and a washer. Normally what we do, we're gonna put that seal right on the top here. Now, we supplied a washer, the kit comes with it. I don't personally use the washer. Okay, I just put the washer aside. The reason being is if you tighten this nut down, if you can get it threaded on there, right? Golly, Jeff. Here we go. All right, tighten that dude down. Not like totally so it bends your air cleaner lid and all that stuff, but you know, do it snug. Dude, this thing is tight. It's not gonna move. With that EPDM seal right there, it acts like a lock washer and doesn't scratch up the lid, and it seals, so your carburetor, the air cleaner assembly is not gonna leak air, okay? That's it, that's pretty much it. I mean, any engine we built here at the Kaddie Shack is gonna have high flows on it, okay? Any one. That motor we tested with Hot VWs, it had 8 horsepower, like I said. Some motors, a littler motor, that was a 2180 in that car. Littler motor, gonna make a little less horsepower. Stock motor, any motor is gonna make something. It's gonna do something. It's gonna impede, it's not gonna impede that airflow anymore. Any motor is gonna do something, but the bigger motors are going to make more power, the littler motors are going to make less power. Okay, but you're going to get something out of it, and as cheap as it is doing, it's worth doing. There you go. That's our Hi-Flo kit. I'm Jeff. See you at the track.